Welcome to Motorcycle News and welcome to the Yamaha Tricity 300. Three wheels, but one purpose: to get people out of the cars and off of public transport and riding bikes. Three wheels isn't a new idea. Piaggio have done it back in 2006 or so, and Yamaha themselves have been doing it for 6 years with the Tricity 125 and the slightly better known Nikon with its MCN engine. But both of those bikes have one thing in common, which is that technically and legally, they are motorbikes. You needed a bike license to ride them, and if you don't put your feet down at a set of traffic lights, they fall over. And that's where the Tricity 300 is different. This isn't a motorbike. You don't need a bike license to ride it. That comes down to something called the track. Now, in plain English, that's simply the distance between the two front wheels. If that's less than 460 millimeters, it's a motorbike. And on this bike, it's 470 millimeters, which means it's a trike. And that in turn means you can ride it on a car license. All of that technical stuff means this bike isn't really built for the likes of you and me. This is built for people who don't already ride, who are sick of being stuck in their cars on the commute or paying a fortune to park at the train station, or indeed sick of being on trains and buses, which is probably a pretty bad idea at the minute. So having two wheels up front doesn't only let you skip around the license requirements, which makes it a lot cheaper and a lot quicker to get riding, it doesn't add just the perception of confidence, it adds real confidence too. This bike still leans when it goes around corners due to having the same four fork double parallelogram setup as the Tricity 125 and the Nikon. Although the feel isn't quite the same as having a regular telescopic fork, the sensation of grip, the reassurance, the stability is miles higher than any conventional two-wheeled scooter. So it's a real thing. If you are riding for the first time, this is a great way to get on board and to give it a go and feel like you run less risk of something unpleasant happening when it's raining. Another thing that's new for this bike that will definitely appeal to car drivers is a button up on this switch gear, which locks the bike upright when you come to a standstill. Now, the Tricity 125 and the Nikon didn't have this. Piaggio's MP3 did. And I think that was one of the big elements that helped attract car drivers. This bike isn't on its stand at the minute. This is, you can just roll it around, push it about. And it not only means it's a little bit easier to sit on a set of traffic lights. It means if you've got some fancy shoes, they don't have to get wet if you're in that London. And actually just simply handling the bike around at a standstill is a lot easier. Because this is not a light motorbike. Although everything from kind of here backwards is the same as the X-Max 300, this clever front end system adds a whopping 60 kilos of weight. So the whole thing you see here is 239 kilos. Not a huge amount in bike terms, but an awful lot in scooter terms. Now that also does have a slight knock-on effect on the performance of the bike. The engine is exactly the same 292cc 4-valve water-cooled single as in the X-Max 300. It makes the same 28 horsepower, but obviously it's pushing a lot more weight, and that does mean it's not the quickest thing in the world. It's certainly brisk enough for riding around town, and it'll hold its own on a motorway. It's a little bit sluggish above kind of 60, but you can, if you're determined, push it onto an indicated 85-ish. So, not super fast, but certainly enough to get the job done if you're just doing a bit of commuting. The other thing that slightly suffers because of the weight is the brakes. There's a pair of discs at the front, obviously, each with just a single piston caliper. Now, there really isn't very much bite at all, but there is a lot of power. You just have to squeeze hard. Now, for a motorcyclist, it doesn't feel the most inspiring setup, but it's probably been designed for people who don't have a huge amount of riding experience. And that's good because it means they won't catch themselves out by grabbing a handful when they panic, and then the whole bike ends up in a bit of a pickle. The other thing that helps that is that this bike not only has three-channel ABS, but it also has a link brake system between the two brakes at the front and the one at the back. So if you squeeze the right lever, you just get the front brakes. If you squeeze the left lever, you get all three applied at once. And on top of that, if you don't fancy using your hands at all, you can brake with this foot brake, and that puts all three brakes on at once. It's a bit of an odd setup, but it doesn't take too long to get used to it. And at the end of the day, you end up squeezing both levers equally anyway. Physically, this is quite a large, wide machine. Now, a lot of people think that because it's quite a wide bike, they're going to struggle to filter through gaps on it. In truth, the widest part of it is the handlebars, and at 815 millimeters, it's actually not a huge amount wider than the X-Max 300. And in motorcycling terms, it's still slimmer than, say, a Tenere 700 or a Tracer 900, so it's certainly not a big, fat, old bulbous whale of a thing. The other positive of all the extra width is the weather protection. It rained pretty much all morning today, and I'm in my very trendy jeans, which have stayed perfectly dry. And as well as this big screen, which comes up a lot higher than on certain maxi scoots, which does add a lot of weather protection. The only slight niggle with that is that for an average sized human being like me, it's kind of just sitting in your eye line. It could just kind of do with making its mind up whether it wants to go higher or lower, or indeed have some adjustability. Unfortunately, this is fixed. Other bits and bobs, well, there's keyless ignition, there's traction control, which you can't imagine ever needing, but these are all things that just help add familiarity and reassurance to car drivers. These are all words and gadgets that they've come to know and love, and this is what they would expect on a bike costing £7,500. Yes, that is a huge amount of money in motorcycling terms. That is a £2,000 premium on the XMAX 300. However, an XMAX 300 isn't really a rival for it. We can sit here and moan about cost and weight and whatever else and compare it to motorcycles and scooters all day long. But the person who's going to buy one of these isn't going to buy a scooter or a motorcycle. Their choice is between this and a car or a train. And have you seen the cost of train tickets these days? You can get one of these, Tricity 300 on PCP with a £1,500 deposit for about £90 a month. And that is the kind of money that some people spend parking their car at train stations. Really, if it came down to a decision between sitting in a car or sitting on a train being coughed on by strangers or riding one of the most confidence-inspiring and, dare I say it, bloody good fun mid-range scooters you can get out there, I'd take this every day of the week.